Learners, welcome to Ash Education. Today we will see how to draw the process infographic. Three heading, three numbered and font infographic. Let's see how to draw it. Take a fresh new slide. Under insert, go to shapes and choose the parallelogram. Draw the parallelogram without pressing the shift key. Remove the shape outline and rotate it to flip horizontally. Then again go to insert and choose the arrow shape. Draw the arrow shape without pressing the shift key. Remove the shape outline and adjust its size to align with your parallelogram. Again, rotate your arrow and then under format shapes, merge it with the parallelogram. Go to insert, under shapes, choose the parallelogram again and draw it. Remember not to press the shift key. Remove the shape outline. And now adjust its size to the top arrow. Once the size is adjusted, you can rotate it to flip horizontally. And then you align it and you can increase its tilt a little and also increase the length of the parallelogram, just as it is shown. Duplicate your arrow on the first top and rotate it to flip horizontally. So now you have arrows in two different directions. Now you have to align your arrow. So I'm shifting it to the left. I have chosen another parallelogram and this is going to be used for the shadow effect. So first increase and adjust its size between the two figures. Adjust it to the center. And increase the tilt a lot. So you see that the size of this parallelogram and the size of the arrows is different. Duplicate the same parallelogram and then use it as a shadow for the second and third arrow. Shift their positions to align them together and now this is ready. Select all of them and group by pressing Ctrl G. Then you can increase their size if you like. Again, ungroup it. And now you can begin to color. Select the first arrow. Go to format shape under right click. Under the fill, choose the desired color from the eyedropper tool. Go to shadow and give a desired shadow. I have chosen a downward shadow. And now I'm adjusting the slice and burr. I'm happy with this effect. I'll go to home, click on format painter and then click on my next arrow. So now my shadow effect has been copied to all. Now I will begin coloring the other objects and then my figure is going to be ready. So I have chosen a light and dark color theme here. Last one is green color. So I am happy with this color. Now I will show you how to put the text here. So click the text box. Here you can put your title. I'll show you how to make one and I have the others ready. I will choose the Museo font. Increase the looseness of the text. Give it some bold effect and shadow effect. Now duplicate the same and this I will use for the subtitle. Or any other extra information that you want to put in. I will duplicate this and now I will enter my number here. So this is going to be my first step in the process. I'll increase its size because that is how the design of my font and infographic is. Now go to insert and choose a rectangle. Draw a very thin rectangle and remove its shape outline. Give it the color as that of the first arrow. So it is going to be orange. And you adjust it between the number and your text. So this is how I have made the font information and number here. Now I have the other two ready. So I'm simply going to copy it. And here I'm showing you how to put in your headings. Now with the heading, I'm going to again give some bold and shadow effect. Increase its size. Choose the Museo font. And also increase the looseness of the text or the spacing between the alphabets. go to Format Painter and apply the effect on all the three headings. And now your figure is ready. I'll copy paste the other two numbers. So I have shown you how to make one and the other two are ready. I'll delete the extra. So on account of Indian Independence Day, I have chosen the orange, blue and green color theme. So give this infographic a try. Let me know how it works out.